So in exercise 1.4, already we have completed 6 questions. Now let me move to the 7th one. In each of the following cases, we have to state whether the function is bijective or not. We have to justify our answer. So our first part is, function is R to R defined by f of x equal to 2x plus 1. And second part, function is R to R defined by f of x equal to 3 minus 4x square. So in solution, R belongs to rational numbers and you already know that it starts in negative infinity and ends in positive infinity including 0. When I start with f of x equal to 2x plus 1, I'll substitute minus 2 in the place of x. I'll get f of minus 2 equal to 2 into minus 2 plus 1, that is equal to minus 3. And when I substitute minus 1 in the place of x, I'll get f of minus 1 equal to 2 into minus 1 plus 1, that is equal to minus 1. When I substitute 0 in the place of x, I'll get f of 0 equal to 2 into 0 plus 1, that is equal to 1. And when I substitute 1 in the place of x, I'll get f of 1 equal to 2 into 1 plus 1, that is equal to 3. When I substitute 2 in the place of x, I'll get f of 2 equal to 2 into 2 plus 1, that is equal to 5. So this is the arrow diagram for this function. So from the arrow diagram, you may already know that it is one-to-one function where distinct element of A have distinct image in B, and it is also onto because every element in B has an image on A, the given function is bijective. So our second part's function is R to R defined by f of x equal to 3 minus 4 x square. And I substitute minus 2 in the place of x, I'll get f of minus 2 equal to 3 minus 4 into minus 2 the whole square, that is equal to minus 13. When I substitute minus 1 in the place of x, I'll get f of minus 1 equal to 3 minus 4 into minus 1 the whole square, that is equal to minus 1. When I substitute 1 in the place of x, I'll get f of 1 equal to 3 minus 4 into 1 the whole square, that is equal to minus 1. When I substitute 2 in the place of x, I'll get f of 2, that is equal to 3 minus 4 into 2 square, that is equal to minus 13. So the arrow diagram for this function is here. So now you know that from the arrow diagram, you know that it is many to one function. That is, two or more elements of A have same image in B. So it is not bijective. So in our ninth question, if the function f is defined by f of x, where we have given three functions. First is x plus 2, and where x is greater than 1. And second is 2 if x is greater than or equal to minus 1 and smaller than or equal to 1. And our third function is x minus 1 and it is greater than minus 3 and smaller than 1. We have to find the values of f of 3, f of 0, f of minus 1.5 and f of 2 plus f of minus 2. So this is the number line for this function. So our f of 3 belongs to this group. That is x plus 2. Sorry, here it is x plus 2, where 3 plus 2 equal to 5. And our f of 0 lies here this, in the 2 group, where that is equal to 2. And our f of minus 1.5 lies in this group, that is x minus 1, that is equal to minus 1.5 minus 1, that is equal to minus 2.5. So f of 2 plus f of minus 2 equal to x plus 2 plus x minus 1. That is 2 plus 2 plus minus 2 minus 1. That is equal to 4 plus minus 3. That is equal to 4 minus 3. So our f of 2 plus f of minus 2 equal to 1. So in our 8th question, let a equal to minus 1 comma 1 and b equal to 0 comma 2. We have to find if the function f a to b is defined by f of x equal to ax plus b is an onto function. We have to find a and b. It is given that it is an onto function. Now, we already know about onto function, that is, every element in B has a pre-image in A. So I have drawn two arrow diagrams based on the values of a and b. So these are the two, and I have got two functions list. That is, one is minus 1, 0 and 1, 2, and the second one is -1,2 and 1,0. So I am taking the first function values to find a and b, that is -1,0 and 1,2. First, I am substituting f of x equal to -1,0, that is equal to y value I am putting here and x value I will multiply inside. So 0 equal to a into -1 plus b, that is equal to 0 equal to -a plus b. So minus a will come this side and will become a equal to b. Now we have found the relation between a and b. We'll find the values. When I substitute 1 and 2 in f of x, I'll get y value, that is 2, equal to a into x value, that is 1 plus b. So 2 equal to Rekala. Okay. So I'm substituting a value as b here. So it will become b plus b, that is equal to 2 equal to 2b, and b equal to 2 by 2, that is equal to 1. So if b is 1, then a should also be 1 because we have found a equal to b. In our 10th question, a function f -5,9 is r is defined as follows: f of x equal to 6x plus 1, and it is given that x is greater than or equal to -5 and smaller than 2, and the second function is 5x square minus 1, and it is x is greater than or equal to 2 and smaller than 6. In the third function, 3x minus 4, where x is greater than or equal to 6 and smaller than or equal to 9. So this is our number line for this three functions. So we are given to find that first part, f of minus 3 plus f of 2, second part, f of 7 minus f of 1, third part, 2 into f of 4 plus f of 8, and fourth part, 2 into f of minus 2 plus f of 6 by f of 4 plus f of minus 2. So in our solution, first we are finding f of minus 3. So it belongs to the function 6x plus 1. So I am substituting x value as minus 3. I'll get 6 into minus 3 plus 1, that is equal to minus 18 plus 1, that is equal to minus 17. And my f of 2 is belongs to f 5x square minus 1. When I substitute 2 in the value of x, I'll get 5 into 2 square minus 1, that is equal to 20 minus 1 equal to 19. And when I add these values, I'll get minus 17 plus 19 equal to 2. So in this, I'm first finding f of 7, then f of 1, then I'll subtract it. So my f of 7 belongs to the function 3x minus 4. When I substitute 7 in the place of x, I'll get 3 into 7 minus 4, that is equal to 17. And my f of 1 belongs to 6x plus 1 function. And when I substitute 1 in the place of x, I'll get 6 into 1 plus 1, that is equal to 7. And when I subtract it, I'll get 17 minus 7 equal to 10. So in this function, I'll first find f of 4, then f of 8, then we'll add it. Okay, f of 4 belongs to the function 5x square minus 1. When I substitute 4 in the place of x, I'll get 5 into 16 minus 1 equal to 79. And f of 8 belongs to 3x minus 4. When I substitute 8 in the place of x, I'll get 3 into 8 minus 4, that is equal to 20. So now I am putting the f of 4 and f of 8 values here. So 2 into 79 plus 20, that is equal to 158 plus 20 equal to 178. So my fourth part is to find 2 into f of minus 2 minus f of 16 by f of 4 plus f of minus 2. First I am finding f of minus 2. I'll get 6x plus 1, that is, it belongs to the function 6x plus 1. And substituting minus 2 in the place of x, I'll get 6 into minus 2 plus 1, that is equal to minus 11. And I'm finding f of 6, it belongs to the function 3x minus 4. When I substitute 6 in the place of x, I'll get 3 into 6 minus 4, that is equal to 14. When I find f of 4, I already found it in the previous part, that is 79. And f of minus 2 belongs to the group 6x plus 1. So that is, when I substitute minus 2 in the place of x, I'll get 6 into minus 2 plus 1, that is equal to minus 12 plus 1, that is equal to minus 11. So now I'm just substituting the values of these functions. So 2 into minus 1 minus 11 minus 14 by 79 minus 11 equal to minus 22 minus 14 by 68. So when I cancel these all, I'll get minus 9 by 17.